In this module, we're going to talk about the Azure Active Directory, but specifically B2C. So we have different modules that are kind of evolving in our Azure Active Directory scope to allow us to basically extend Azure Active Directory to other identity providers. Think about a federated type model. That's really what we're after here. But it kind of goes beyond that. It kind of helps users to basically connect other types of identity providers in such a way that we're also still able to semi kind of manage or allow those users to be managed inside of an application inside Azure Active Directory. So if we took a look at what we traditionally have, typically what we have with Azure Active Directory is that's a directory of names, right? So we would have our users defined in here for an application, let's say, and over here's our app, right? This app is going to use this. It's going to prompt a user for credentials when they log into the application. Everything works fine. Now, what happens is people are saying, well, we don't necessarily just need to use all these. Let's say these are like our corp users. Maybe we also want to use people from like Facebook, right? So in this case, now how do we connect the Facebook users, right? We could augment our application over here to support Facebook, right? But that's kind of messy, right? Because now every time we want to do a provider, if we want to do Google, now we have to add those guys on there, right? Each time we're having to extend our application in order to support those. And the idea was, can we come up with a way that makes it easier for people to do that? So it looks like maybe they're hitting Azure Active Directory, and basically we can prompt them for the credentials for whatever we need here, what other identity providers. And maybe there's more come out in the future that we want to go ahead and extend this out to. And so that's kind of the model between these kind of things. What's actually happening behind the scenes is when we provision a user that's in, let's say, Facebook into our application, we'll go through a configuration, and I'll show you that in a second. But once we do the configuration, these guys actually, we're basically storing a little, like, you can think of it as like a little placeholder over here, right, to that user. It's not their credentials or any of that kind of stuff. It's just like when someone hits this and says, hey, I want to authenticate, it says, oh, that's a Facebook one. Let's go ahead and authenticate them via Facebook. It will do that Facebook authentication and let them log into the application. And this little thing here, we can also tie R back to, which is really nice. So like if we had in our application things that says, you know, user A can do this and user B can do this, but maybe they're using two different identity providers. Well, that would be kind of messy if we had to put all that in our code. So the idea here is to kind of decouple that a little bit and allow people to use different identity providers, but use the same kind of model behind the scenes when you're building your application so you can kind of wire those things together. And I want to show you in the portal what this actually looks like, because it's a little bit of a back and forth here. So when we come into the portal, and actually you'll see that I'm in the old portal here. Let's just pop up to the root here. So I'm at, you see, manage at windowsazure.com, the old portal. And so in this case, when we come in here, this is the only way we can manage Active Directory currently, our Azure Active Directory. Once this thing loads, we'll actually see that when we go into our Active Directory, we can provision it. Now, while that's loading, I'm going to show you some of the screens to provision this, because it is a little bit, you have to enable this feature when you're provisioning. So if you come in here under App Services and under Active Directory, and then under Directory, which hasn't loaded because I'm still waiting for the module to load, it is loaded now. Okay, so there it is. So if we pop back over here, you can see directory. Actually, let me scroll down here. You see Active Directory. And then we go under directory, and we want to do a custom create. You see we can go ahead and specify a name, whatever we want to provision. But you see there's a little checkbox down here at the bottom. Zoom in on that guy. So B2C directory. This gets enabled at provisioning time. So you want to think about that whenever you're provisioning your Azure Active Directory, whether you want this directory for your application to use external identity providers. So in this case, if we check that box, and I already have one pre-provisioned, so we don't have to wait for that process, we can actually go in here. You'll see it looks slightly different. So here's a typical just Azure Active Directory one. You'll notice we have all the features in here for when we want to hook it up to an on-premises domain. We have our AD features here, but when you have one that has B2C, you'll notice that we also have this B2C settings option here that gets provisioned. So when you click on that, you actually get directed to the new portal. So the management is being ported over to the new portal for Azure Active Directory, and you can see here's where the settings, and you'll notice also I just want to call this out because it's important that this guy is still in preview form. So this is something probably not for production workloads, but something you should be looking at. So here's our domain that we actually provision. Here's our identity providers that we want to hook up to this thing. We can pick what kind of identifier that we want to use. And when we hit add here, this is where we can actually select from the ones that we have supported right now in the preview, which is Google, Facebook, LinkedIn, Amazon. So you can select each one of these. Let's just say it's Facebook for argument's sake. And then when we come in here again, we would basically have our client ID secret that we're going to put in there, along with the identifier for the application that this is going to target. So that's something you would build in Azure Active Directory, abstract from the identity provider. Once we have that guy wired up, you can see, let me just cancel out some of this, but you can see back here, we actually do have some sort of management policies here, right? So we can do password reset for these guys, like force them to do things. We can't do specifically to say like their password complexity right now. That's a feature I've heard a lot from people to say like, you know, could we control password complexity rules for someone who's using Facebook, for instance? That's not there right now, but what we can do is what's listed here in the portal. And so you want to take a look at those because, especially if you're in a line of business type application and maybe you want to expose this, you want to be aware of the different policies that can be applied to those kind of things around how they sign up as well as when they kind of reset. Those are some of the things that we can trigger right now. And again, this is in preview form, so it's not totally complete yet, but this is where we're going with the actual B2C and being able to connect these external providers to Azure Active Directory. And so that concludes the module on Azure Active Directory B2C.